Hey guys, welcome to the first part of the ASCII RPG tutorial. Our goal is to achieve something like this. In this video, I'll show you the basics and we'll cover the main menu as well as saving and loading the game. Since this is a text-based game, we won't need a graphical window and we're gonna use the terminal. We will use the print and the input functions frequently. With the print, we draw all the stuff to the screen we need, like Hello YouTube. If you use PyCharm, you can hold Shift and press F10 to compile. Then with the input, we either give commands or just hold the code. We can save the input to a string as well and use it later. The game will also have some while loops with the respective booleans. Without inputs, our loop would go on infinitely. For these, I tend to use two types of inputs to tell the player if the game needs a command or just a random input before progressing. The four main boolean that we use now are the run, menu, play, and the rules. The run is basically responsible for running the game. Within this main loop, we will include the menu loop and the play loop. Let's work on the menu first. Now let's include the command options in the menu. The player can choose from these four options. If we start the game, now it will run forever like crazy. We don't want that, so we ask for an input that we save as the choice string. If the player gives something else than these four numbers, the game will ask for the input again. Now let's code that feature. Let's start with the four input, that's for quitting. We just simply put the quit command there. So if we type in 4, the game quits. If we, let's say, smash our head into the keyboard, the game will ask for the input again, just as I told you. Then we can include some rules to give the player instructions. We use the rules boolean here. If the player types 3, then it will be true. Now what happens when it's true is that we print something to the screen. To avoid asking multiple inputs, we can ask for the choice if the rules bool is false. We should ask for a random input that will hold the information on the screen. And to avoid getting stuck here, we set the rules to false and we reset the choice. Now if we try it, you can see it works flawlessly. Now let's go ahead and make the new game prompt. Let's ask for the player's name. We can save it to the name string. If you don't include a space after the input text, it will look like this. So I recommend putting an extra space there. It looks better. So if the player types 1, we have to get out of the menu loop and get into the play loop. Now let's check it. Great! Okay, now let's leave an input here too. Since we're gonna move around the map, I will call this string dest like destination. We will fill this part later, but I'll show you how to get back to the main menu. It's really simple. Let's make another if statement. So if we type 0, the game will reverse these booleans and we get back to the menu. Awesome! Now let's make the saving. For this, we will make a save function without arguments. In this function, we will create a list that will contain the stats of the player. For the sake of demonstration, let's make some more stats, like health points and damage. We'll cover the rest in the next video. We can include these ones in the list as well. To avoid unnecessary crashing, be sure to convert these integers to strings. Now we want to open the load.txt file in write mode that's in the directory of the game. If there's no such file, the game will create one. Again, make sure to include the W for write mode. Then for every item in the list that are the name, HP and attack, we will write them into the file while separating them with new lines. Then we close the file. The save function is done. Now let's include it somewhere. If you want auto-saving, you can put it at the start of the play loop and you can also save manually if, let's say, you go back to the menu. Now you can see that the folder only has this main.py file. If we start the game, type 1, give our name, then quit, we can see that the save file is created. Fantastic! Now let's use that save file. This will happen if the player types 2 in the main menu. Keep in mind, if the file is not there, the game will crash. Now we open this file again, like last time, but in a reading mode with the R flag. We will put its context into a list with the readlines function. Then we can save these list elements as the stats of the player. Remember the order, first is the name, second is the HP, and third is the attack. We can check it now. but you can see that there's unnecessary new lines there. We can get rid of them by removing the last character of these strings. Great, now the loading is working. We can include some welcome text here, why not? Let's say welcome back, add the name to the string. There we go. Waiting for an input. And starting the game. Now let's check what we created in the terminal, aka command prompt. This works for me by simply double-clicking the main.py file in its directory. Rules. New game. Name. Quit the menu. Load. Okay, it's working, but as you can see, it's always printing under the stuff on the screen, which doesn't look so appealing in my opinion. Fortunately, there's an easy fix for that. Let's import our first built-in library called OS. Then we can create another function that I'll name clear, and we write the os.systemcls command there. That's it. Now we have to call this function wherever we want to clear the screen. Please note that it won't work in PyCharm, neither in idle. It will only yield this character right here. But if we go back to the terminal and try it out here, boom! Magic, it's working! Last thing I wanted to show you is the line drawing function. It's only for cosmetic purposes. Let's create a draw function and simply include a print command there. It's up to you whether you want to use this or not, or if you design it different. Let's call it somewhere. Finishing touches. Now we open the game in the terminal and... wow, looking great! Okay, I hope you could follow along, the next part is coming hopefully tomorrow. We'll cover the player stats, refine the saving, then make the map and the movement. Thanks for watching, see you in the next part, stay safe and take care!